Hey guys, it's Nicole. It's Wednesday, so it's hashtag Ask Nicole as always. And a lot of you viewers out there keep asking me what traits or qualifications make you a good nurse. And I have to tell you that there is no particular trait. I've had tons of jobs from retail to fast food, and I was pretty terrible at them. I was a server once. I would always forget to roll my silverware at the end of my shift. I always got yelled at about that. Welcome to Red Lobster. My name's Nicole. I'm going to be your server today. How can I help you? I would forget to get my customer their drinks. I would let them order, like, let's say salmon, and then we've been 86 salmon for the past 5 hours. I was a terrible server.
86 salmon, Nicole. We've already told you 4 times. We don't have salmon at all. Quit letting people order it.
Oh, I forgot your silverware. I will be right back. I'm sorry. Oh, you wanted a soda? Oh, it's not Coke? Oh, I forgot your bread. I'll be right back. Oh, yeah. Okay, you wanted ketchup? I'll be right back. And if for some reason you guys think that your previous kind of career or jobs, your experience is going to be the exact same experience when you enter nursing school, and that is not true. When you find something that clicks for you and that you love and that you're passionate about, things go well because you are invested in that career. I worked as a secretary in an engineering firm. I didn't like that either. And I felt like I sucked at all these other jobs. So of course, when I became a nurse, I would suck. And that's not true, because if you love something, you are emotionally involved, you're invested in it, and you have a complete different experience. When it comes to school, that did not come, you know, second nature to me. I had to struggle for every single B and C that I received. And a lot of people get straight A's and, you know, they think that that's going to translate into you being a good nurse. And that is not the case. Just because you are difficult, you know, as far as grasping concepts in school, that doesn't mean that you're going to be a terrible nurse. There is not one trait or one type of personality that could give you a glimpse into what being a good nurse is. You become a good nurse by learning your lessons and loving to care for people. That's really it. I'm not underestimating, you know, what it takes to be a nurse. If you truly, truly care, all the other drama and stuff falls by the wayside. But if you can pass the prerequisites, you know, the admissions process, the entire nursing journey, and you become a nurse, that's all you need. The rest of the journey is up to you and how you perceive your experiences, but there is not one detail that makes you a great nurse. If you're disorganized, that's okay, because I was completely disorganized when I started out in my nursing program. Are you always late for things? That's okay, because I was always late to my other jobs and even sometimes to the courses in my nursing program. But you realize what things you can push and what you can't push in your nursing program. You modify, you adapt, and you move on. And you grow as like an individual while you're in this program. Do not underestimate the power of personal growth. Do not let your past or your present even scare you out of the entire nursing journey and experience itself. You are amazing whether you have medical experience or you don't, because again, the core value is taking care of people. As long as you do that, you're fine. The other objectives will fall, you know, in the proper sequences. But just because you make straight A's throughout your entire high school and your college does not mean you're going to be a great nurse. I've seen many nurses who graduate with honors and all that jazz, and then they come to work on the floor and they're terrible at it. So do not let your grades or your low GPA, which I have one, stop you from doing what you love. Because once you get there, the gates will open and you will be awesome. I promise you. Hang in there. Do not let the daily life and the drama that is life stress you out. You're going to be just fine and you're going to be amazing. And you're awesome. So stop doubting yourself and keep going. As always, if you have any questions or comments for me, put those bad boys below. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you next Wednesday. Bye.